Well, hello, friends. This is Tim Corvin coming to you from my home in Tennessee. And a while back, I told some of you about a unique home project that I recently completed. And some of you said that you were interested in seeing it. And I thought that rather than taking photos, I would shoot this video and post it. Now, I purchased my mobile home back in 2002, and one of the key selling points, the reason why I specifically picked this one, what I liked the most about it was the fact that it had this bay window in the back. And pretty much from the first day that I bought it, I had envisioned that someday I would turn this bay window into a wildlife habitat of some kind. And it took me 14 years to do it, but I finally got around to it recently, more specifically a reptile habitat, but we'll go inside now and take a look at it. Alright, well, the mesh walls here, the outer ones are stationary, they're anchored to the wall, and in the center here, as you can see, I've got a dual door. And the inside is pretty symmetrical. As you can see up here on the top, I have my night light on the left and the daylight on the right, and then down at the bottom it's the opposite, the daylight's on the left and the night light's on the right. And the flooring is pretty symmetrical, what's in the right cove is the same as what's in the left. And I have my thermometers here to monitor the temperatures, the lower and the upper. And sometimes it does get a little hot in there for them, and when it does, I take them out. And now let's meet the inhabitants. Well, this is Lily. She's a standard green iguana, and she's the only iguana that lives in this habitat here. I actually have two iguanas. My other one, Herman, he's a more rare blue iguana, so he has twice the value of Lily as far as what I paid for him. And Herman, unfortunately, he doesn't play very nicely. He picks on Lily a lot and chases her around and bobs his head at her and bites at her and stuff. So until he can learn to play nicely, I have him living in solitary confinement in my living room. And this is the rest of the inhabitants here, my python snakes. They're all three the same species. They're all ball pythons, but they're all unique in their own way. In the ball python trade, breeders do genetic morphing where they breed them and create unique colors and patterns and stuff, and these have all been genetically morphed. And I've seen some of them sell for as much as $5,000 on the market. These are nowhere near that, but the average ball python, you can get them in a pet shop for anywhere from $40 to $75, and these are worth about two or three times that much. Up here at the top we have Mary Ann, and she's what's known as a ghost ball python. She has normal patterns, but her color compared to the average ball python is rather faint. And when she's getting ready to shed, she takes on kind of a ghostly appearance. And down here at the bottom, we have Ginger, and Ginger also has normal patterns, but her color compared to an average ball python is very bright. This is what's known as a pastel ball python. So she's like the opposite of Mary Ann. Mary Ann's colors are faint and hers are bright. And here in the middle, we have Gilligan. He's the most unique one of them all. As you can see, he has somewhat of a yellowish tint to him, so he's what's known as a lemon blast. And as you can see, the patterns here are much different than the others. This is what's known as a pinstripe pattern. So as you might have guessed, I am obviously a child of 1960s TV sitcoms with snake names of Gilligan, Ginger, and Mary Ann, and my iguanas Herman and Lily, whom I named after the Munsters. The one problem that I anticipated I might have with this, I've heard that snakes can be very territorial and they don't like to share their space with others. So I thought that that might be a problem, but that has not been the case here. In fact, it's very common I'll find all three of them huddled up together. And as you can see, Lily has no problem with them. She loves the snakes. She knows that they're her friends. It's kind of weird that the only other pet that she's afraid of is her fellow iguana, Herman, who always picks on her. In fact, the snakes, unbeknownst to them, they protect Lily. They protect her from Herman. I've seen times where Herman will be making his way over to pick on her, and before he gets to her, he'll see that there's a snake between them, and then he'll stop and he won't take another step further. So the snakes are Lily's bodyguard. They protect her. So these are my kids. I love them like they're my children. And they're a joy to have.
Go on, sneak a peek. It won't hurt for long.
Thank you.
I'm